So this time I'm going to take a little bit different approach to the container checklist for my blog post. This time I'm going to basically this time I have a guest, so to speak, a virtual machine, and I'm going to assign two static IP addresses. I'm going to use the network interface alias functionality, I guess, so that I can actually assign alias. I can actually create aliases of a single network interface. That mean that allows me to basically associate two IP addresses to a single network interface, and that allows me to do some what I guess I would call IP based virtual hosting. And so I will all set up two containers, each with a different IP address, using the same network interface, and then basically I'll expand a little bit on that by creating users for each container, and then allowing those users to basically log straight into their container using the IP address assigned to their container. So the first step, and I should actually also make notes there, because I tried this before again and was basically hell on earth. So the first step, I think, would be to get rid of network manager, get rid of network manager, and that's basically done by system control disable network manager service. And then you could enable this way system control enable network service, but you can also just use check config straight up. Check config, and I think it's enable, or maybe it's actually just the other way around. That's why I'm always so confused. Check config and then network enable, something like that, or network on, actually something like that. But anyways, well, you just use system control for that. But let's just log in first. SSH 192.168.100, and it's 164 is the IP address, I believe. Yep. And then sudo shell abc123. So if I use check config, then you'll see that the network is set to off by default, and that network manager is actually on by default. PS aux grab network manager, grab I network manager, and you see that network manager is running. Now there's a problem here, that and not sure if this is just my mistake, that I do something wrong or not, but I can't get network manager to work consistently with network interface aliases. So that's why I'm just suggesting here disable the network manager service and enable network service instead. But we can already start. Well, let's just do this already. Step one. So system control, and then see where it gets us. Disable network manager service, and it'll get rid of some shit. And then system control enable network service. And this will spit out some information, but if you now look at your config, you'll see that it's enabled. So it did do it right. It just puts on some information that how it works and that it should that there's no service file, I guess. But it knew what I meant. So right now, then the second thing you want to do is actually set up your static IP address for your main, for your single network interface. So if I do IP link show, then you'll see that I have a single IP address here. Sorry, a single network interface, and I want to basically assign static IP to that stuff. So you'll go to cd etc sysconfig, and then network scripts, and then just basically nano efcfg eth0. Now by default it's set to get or use DHCP, so we'll want to basically set that to static, and then we need to actually let's just remove this DHCP hostname as well, because actually I'll just comment it out because, well, we no longer use DHCP, so that's not gonna happen either. But we need to actually set up static IP, so I don't know this off the top of my head, so hopefully I'll right. Now I had a problem when I tried this previously with whoops. So one of the most common blah blah blah. The following is a sample of the ETH0 file for a system using fixed address. The values required. Which version is this? 6? Yeah, 6. The templates and other values. Let's see what it says for gateway. Because I had a problem with that, my containers did not have a default gateway set, so I had to script that in a very ugly way, and it's actually not even there. Funk. Oh, boot protocol is none. Weird. I would have sworn it would be static, but and then just put in the so since DHCP is assigning IP addresses from, I think, starting 128 to 254 or 253 or something like that, I'll just I'll just use something outside of the DHCP range. Let's just verify that. So on the host, ps aux DNS. And then look for its network one, look for the configuration, and then I can actually determine, oops, which range it's using. So it's from 128.254.254, so I need to stay below 128 with my static IP addresses. And the gateway itself is 1. So starting with 10 is fine. Alright, so what about the gateway? Doesn't tell me much. The Usenet control is disabled by default, no need to specify that network controlled, network manager controlled. I'm not sure if that actually still applies. The weird thing is it doesn't mention the gateway anywhere. Configure VLAN network. For shits and giggles, I add this network stuff in here. Kinda sucks. But anyways, if I did it wrong, I'll just work around it. Here you have this static routes and default gateway. Default gateway is determined by the network script part of network, which parse the network scripts to its part. Let's have a read this a little bit. Yeah, gateway is reactive as read from this component. The default route does come in again with equipment directive and specified globally. Interface specific. The default route can thus be indicated by means of the gateway directive and can be specified either globally or in interface specific configuration files. Specify the gateway globally has certain advantages in static network and environments, especially if more than one network interface is available. It can make fault finding simpler if applied consistently. And then here it's in dynamic routing the mobile. Right. Let's read this. In dynamic network environments where mobile hosts are managed by a network manager, gateway information is likely to be interface specific and is best left to be assigned with DHCP. In special cases where it's necessary to influence network manager selection of the exit interface to be used to reach a gateway, make use of the dev route. No. I'll specify the gateway here as well. I'm not sure about this shit, but I had the same issue previously. I just, when it comes to networking, it's just so this should basically set up static IP. Now I could basically create a alias, IFCFG ETH 0, and then edit that. And then basically the device should be that. And then this shit can be removed. I can remove this shit as well. This looks nasty. Let's see if this actually even works. Shit down. Reboot. Now I had to reboot anyways because I did updates and I hadn't rebooted after that. But this is a shitty bit. Nope. Something went wrong. Oh, actually, no, that's just the way it that's just the way it's represented. See, it's shown here. And I do have two IP addresses. So I guess that's fine. I need to get used to IP. Okay, so I guess that's set up. And then basically from then on in, it's pretty much using the familiar steps from my blog post. Which is, step one is to install the dependencies. I will modify that a little bit. Instead, let's just have a look. So instead of installing this, only this, we'll also enclose. We'll actually remove policy core utils Python. And instead we'll install libvirt-login-shell. And the strange thing is it still has the hostname of test for some reason. Alright, that'll take care of step one. Or yeah, actually by now more static IP and then NIC alias. Not nice. That's that. So let's disable firewall daemon and let's just paste this shit in, which sets up some default firewall configuration, and then just enable IP tables instead, and that'll take care of that part. Right, so now we need to create some networks. Now I'm just going to cp this one here, cp, and I'll call this my network 1 XML. And my network 2 XML, and then basically just edit them. So the first one, my network one, we just edited network one. This is third bridge 0, that's fine. We'll leave this indeed to this range. This should be okay. Do the same for network 2, but then different. And this is third bridge 1. Let's have a look if I did that right. Yeah, I did that. Seemed to be doing that right. Alright, so now let's just use netdefine first. Oh, actually, I need to reboot again. I need to make sure that libvirt is up. Oh, and by the way, as soon as you start with the network service, you'll get this thingy here, broken pipe, where you actually need to hit Control C to get out of your shell. So IP address, shell, is it still okay? Oh, let's just sudo first. IP address show. We still have the two IP addresses, and then let's check IP tables to see if the rules were applied properly, and that seems to be applied properly. So the IP tables not, but this empty is all as well. Yeah, it's empty. So yeah, this is applied properly. Yeah, this is okay. All right, so netdefine. So we're in our home directory, so we still have those two networks there. So it's basically verse netdefine, and then it's my network one. XML and my network 2 XML. Now we have two networks. Let's set them both to auto start. So they're both set to auto start, and then we actually need to modify quite a bit, because these default networks they're just not configured properly. Let's start with my network one. No, that's not right. So first we need to do what it says here, basically change. Why, actually, let's just first do something else. So let's go to the host, for example, just for an example, and then verse net define, or actually net edit network one. Have a look at how that's done here. So it has a little bit different forward block there. We're going to just use that as inspiration. So we'll just edit the forward block with what we got here, and then just change that to our particular configuration. So we don't have EM1, we have ETH0. This is for network 1. And so remove this block here, and then while we add it, also add the block here, the net block here, network address translation block here. Probably. Well, not quite, but that's fine, it'll format that properly. Now I guess we can just basically copy this over here and use that. So we'll save and exit this one, and then add it to, and then insert here. And then just change this. And this is not ETH0, this is ETH, this is this one. And this can be removed. And that should, oh, actually, forgot to change the IP address. We'll set this to 1 through 3. Because yeah, well, the my network one is using this range, so we don't want two networks using the same ranges. All right, and then writing quit. And then at this point, we'll just create the DH client service, which is basically copy and paste this in. That'll take care of that. And at this point, I want to reboot again. Well, I don't actually need to reboot now. Let's just create our containers at this point. Just use this. And I'll create a container 1 and container 2. And I'll leave the networking DHCP, but I'll change the source network, which is my network 1. And I'll do similar for 2, but then use my network 2. Right, so now we have those two specified. Now we need to actually edit the configuration file. My container 1. We're about to set up the. Oh, it's actually just container 1. The SE Linux. Compartmentalization. So I'll just specify add some compartments here, C1 and C2. And for container 2, I'll use C3 and C4. And then I need to actually assign those compartments also to the file systems that were just created. So I'll use C1 and C2 for container 1. And for container 2, I'll use C3 and C4. And just LS it to show you it. So those are compartmentalized, the file systems. Right, so now I need to take care of static DHCP so that the stuff gets a static IP address. So I need to determine the interface, network interface, MAC address. And that's net, and then actually edit the network. So first net edit, and then it's my network 1 because container 1 is associated with network 1. And then basically I'll paste this in here to clear my buffer, to make my buffer available, and then just copy this over. And then just edit that. So this IP address is fine, but the host name is container 1. And the MAC address needs to be changed as well. Alright, that's that. This is set up, writing quit. Do similar for container 2, get the MAC address, and this one is associated with network 2. Same idea, just a little bit different, in that we have a different IP address here on this network. Container 2 is the name, and then the MAC address is different. And then write quit. Okay, that should be set up. Alright, so now it's getting a little bit ugly, in that we need to configure network address translation. So we need to create a dir here, or forwarding actually, and then just get that script, and then basically chmod it, and then we need to edit it, because now we're dealing with two networks, and this is a little bit ugly. You can't create two scripts for each one for each network. That's not what gonna work, because the how it works is it associates the name of the script to the protocol that's used. So the script is called LXC, and that's how it's going to look up the containers. It knows, okay, this is about LXC containers only. So what we need to do is actually let's just first deal with the container 1, and this is basically ETH 0, isn't it? Now I'm confused. Let's just oops. IP address show, it's ETH 0. Yeah. So I'll just first we'll deal with the primary container, ETH 0, and that's 192.168. And then it's 100 and then 10, that's the external IP, and vertbridge 0 is associated with this network, and then the name of the machine is container 1. And then let's just change this as well, container 1. This is a little bit messy, and it's a hack. Not even sure if it works 100%, but at least I got it to at least work a little bit reliably. And then remove this thing here, because we actually want to... The IP is 122, and the host name is container 1. Now, what we're doing here is we're just creating some new variables. We'll keep these, but we'll additionally add some, and these we'll just call a external and a external IP and a machines, and then just change those to reflect the settings. Now the interface here is still ETH0, so normally you would probably say, okay, use ETH0 colon 0, but in this case that's not what you need to do. This should be the way, this should be fine. And then actually need to specify this one. Yeah, I'll specify it here below, but for these we'll just keep the normal variable names, so like we don't prepend them with a just, and then use the IP address. So yeah, this is a little bit ugly. And now we need to actually first copy this function here, because we're going to create two functions. Alright, so the first function is can stay the same, that's fine. The second function we'll call it a rules updates, and we'll change a little bit there. The for host and machines is for host and a machines, and then for if in external if is for if in a external ifs, and then we need to actually edit the external IP to a external IP, and that should for the function part take care of that. Now basically we need to add the function to the basically to the case. So a rules, a rules, it's ugly, I'll be the first to admit, but at least it seems to work. It worked last time I tried it, so, and that should take care of that. Alright, so next we need to actually reboot. And then what we want to do is verify that the two virtual networks are running and that there's no conflicts there. Sudo shell, and oops, oh, I was still no, oh damn, weird, oh that's fine. Okay, IP address show, do we have, we have a vertbridge 1, this is a little bit, this looks a little bit ugly, and a vertbridge 0, we have the IP addresses are associated with the bridges, and we have the two external, the alias and the main external IP address. This seems to for now all look okay, all looks okay. So what we're going to do now is configure MariaDB. So we'll just edit the configuration for the containers again. Container 1, and insert this file system block so that we can mount the MariaDB configuration files read writable, so that from a container they could be edited in theory. Or yeah, they could be edited, but whoops. Insert, paste that in, and I'll just change the location, of course, container 1, and then write quit, and do similar for container 2. I'll just change that to container 2. So that's set up. Next, I guess we'll start up container 1 with the unit service file, service unit file that was created. And if all is well, it'll start up. My disk is spinning, so it appears it's starting. Okay, let's just do some checking first. We have the compartments associated properly, C1 and C2 to container 1. Let's just see if the file systems are also done properly. And we have file systems also category C1 and C2, so this corresponds the file system compartments with the process compartments of this container. And we have the processes running, we have user sbin dh client, and we have MySQL doing its in the database initialization, and we have Apache in there. Let's have a look at IP address show to see if it has the expected IP address of 122.122.2. And it has the expected IP address of 122.122.2, so that means that DHCP works as well, static DHCP. Let's just change the database configuration. Nano. Oh, actually, well, let's just do this first, but one thing I'm also interested about is actually whether it's got a default gateway. Okay, that's not gonna happen now. This all changed to the configuration directory, which is writable by the container, and then runs the script. Then we have to deal with this one here. I will figure it, we'll see soon enough, by the way, whether the routing it works or not, because if it doesn't work, then I won't have connectivity. Actually, it's var www.html. This is where we're going to plant our WordPress instance, var, and then we'll open access to the public. So now let's just do a now I'm not going to use WordPress. Well, actually, let's try WordPress. Gee, it's not able to resolve. And that means, and that's shitty as hell, but that means that there's no default gateway specified. So yeah, this is a hack. This is going to be a hack, but I'll just do it. CD etc RCD. And this is read-writable, so we can actually just modify, create a nano RC local in there. For some reason, I can't get this to work. I need to actually add a gateway. But I'm not sure. Route at and I'll just use at default gateway route, or it's yeah, I've been here before, as you can see here. You have it, route at, and then default, and then GW, and then the the default gateway, which is 192.168.101, and then the this thingy. Okay. Control X, and then just make that executable. Gmod plus X. Now I could run it now just to and of course the route command is not found. Yum, install net tools. So you want that. And that's probably why it's not. That's actually not sure whether that might actually be related. I haven't had these issues before, but oh. It's just a little bit weird. This is a really just a hack, but you'll probably know what to do better than I do. So anyways, now we can actually wget cd var www.html. And then wget 192.168. I'll just get this from a local site. 254. And then stuff. And then latest. .gzip, isn't it? Yeah, and then tar xzvf latest tar gzip, and then chown recursive apache. Now eventually you want to do a better solution. And then back to our checklist. Well, you want to cd word. Oh, actually, I always keep forgetting that shit. Let's just do it now. Create a database. I forgot that. I'll just use the same shit for both same database names. Different containers anyways. And it's just an example. That's done. And now actually cd WordPress ls, and then basically mv. And then edit that. And then it's just WordPress. Username is also just WordPress. Password is ABC123. Okay, that's set up. Now we're done for that part. And then exit the container. Yeah, right. Exit. Alright, so and then we need to do the same whole dance here for container. Let's just first have a look at IP tables. and see if the rules are added properly. And they were. So I'm looking at this pre-routing rules to determine whether it actually was done properly, and it seems to have been applied properly. Now let's just try the container too. And do the same verification again. 3 and 4 categories, the processes are running, LS all Z, whether the file system is also. This old root stuff is weird. This old root stuff is not classified properly. I wonder why that is. Route. See, there's no default route there, so we need to actually take care of that as well. But this one here, this old route roots location is not compartmentalized properly. Anyways, we'll just edit the database configuration. I don't know why the gateway is not added. Then we'll need to run the script again. Then let's just do this dance again. Same database name, same username. Exit, configure WordPress, remove this one, var www.html. And then allow access. And exit that. Then we go back. And now we actually take care of the this time it's route at gateway 192.168 1331.880, I think. Cmod. And then just run it, etc. RC, not sure. Oh God. Oh yeah, add. Route. And now I should be able to cd var www html and then wget 192.168.1.254 stuff and then latest star gzip. Connection is refused. Let's have a look at the host. Maybe firewall issue. Journal control since 11:43:2:1. You kidding me? Connection refused. Okay, let's have a look at let var log httpd network 2. This was a long time ago. Weird. The proper IP. It looks weird. Right, there's a bug there. There's a bug there. In the network settings. That sucks. First. Edit. And then my network too. And then let's just reboot. It's a little, yeah, I'm a bit confused with that alias stuff, to be honest. And it's still booting. Okay, sudo shell. We need to actually load container 2 again, connect to it. And now run the write command. Oh, there's no routing at all. And there's no default gateway. So yeah, this is going to be hacky as well. This really needs to, there's a lot of hacks, by the way, it's not the only one. But oh well. See var www.html and then wget 192.168.100, oh no, it's 1254 stuff, wait, this. And now it's working. So yeah, there was a bug there. Tar xzvf latest star gzip chown recursive apache wordpress cd wordpress then ls and then basically mv. Almost done, hopefully, if everything is well. Okay, that's dealt with. What else do we have? Nothing else. But we wanna actually edit sandbox one as well, because we really need that sleep stuff. So cd, or actually just nano etc rcd and then rc local and then just actually add the sleep. What, 10 seconds now, wasn't it? Alright, now let's get back, let's get to the last step here, which is basically to create this thing. Now I'm just creating this one and then removing it because we don't have a WordPress container. And then I go all the way up and change that to my requirements. So it's not WordPress container, it's container one. And then I'll just change the description. Container one. Oops. And 30 seconds is fine. And then next I'll add start this one 50 seconds later. Container two. timers. It's a hack, but container one and container two. Now, in theory, everything should work. At least this part should done. We good now. So we have two IP addresses. 192.168.110. Oh, this is from a previous time. WordPress. It seems to not work. Oh, it is. It is working. This is container one. It takes a while. Joe. ABC 123. Joe. It takes a while. First you need to wait 30 seconds for, and this is the other one instance. Why isn't this working? For Christ's sakes. PS aux. We have both containers running. Let's connect the container two because that's the culprit. Route is added. IP address show. Got the IP address. This is set up properly. But it doesn't. IP tables LV. Oh, it does, but it's, damn, that took long. Did work, but for some reason it took long. Not sure what that's all about. But you you should optimize this app, and we should actually really figure out why that routing, why that gateway isn't added. Okay, so now you have different sides. So let's just give this, actually give this this one. Yeah, I like to go to the side. So this is one, this is this one. Let's just go 192.168.10 WordPress and give that another skin. Go to the dashboard, I guess, or teams, and just give this this team, and then go to view the site. So now you can actually see the different containers. Actually, they changed the layout. Seems. But anyways, that works, but it takes a hell of a long time. So on to the last step here is to actually create a couple of users and associate them to the containers. So user add container one, password word container one, ABC123. Okay, then do the same for container two. So now I have two users now, cd home, and I'll just copy my Joe's ones, cpr joe ssh container, container. Then chown recurse container one SSH and container. And then do the same for then nano BTC security. And just take care of that real quick. Container one, container two, and then nano etc ssh sshd config, and then all the way below, append them to allowed users, container one, container two, and then just make the container, or actually make the for libvirt file systems container one, and then home container one, so that container one user has a home directory, and do the same for container two, and then system control restart sshd, and then rpm query list virt login shell. Like virt login shell, and then edit this configuration file here. Copy nano change this one here. Container 1, container 2. And then SSH container 1. Container 1 has the IP address of 192.168.110. And this isn't right. And that's because I forgot something. I forgot to set the shell, which is basically user mod as user libvirt-login-shell and then container 1. How it works. So this is container 1, which is associated with category 1 and 2. Exit, and let's check container 2 on the IP address for container 2. And ID LSLZ, which is 3 and 4, category 3 and 4, so you know that it's a different container there, and then PS out, exit. And now you can actually, I'll just show you that as well, you can do some nice stuff with system cgls. You see how these processes are sliced up, so to speak. You can actually use control groups to basically specify how much resources they can use, and you have also this user list. This is it, probably. Yeah, this is it. So you can also take care of that a little bit. Anyway, it's a lot of nice things to do, but this works. But yeah, there's hacks everywhere, so yeah, need to deal with those as well.